20th century saw the rapid developments in technology, medicine, and science transforming the way we live, work, and understand the universe. It was hard to imagine that just more than 100.5 years ago, the most advanced vehicles still needed to depend on steam and coal for transport. Yet despite this massive changes that swept through the entire world, there is a dark side to this progress that many people don't know about. A world of monopoly, suppression, and conspiracy. A world of betrayal, assassination, and tragedy. As you requested, we continue with them in this third part of our series on banned technologies and the suppression of their inventors. If someone asks you about technologies and inventions that never saw the light of the day, the first name that probably comes to your mind is Nikola Tesla. Nicknamed as the man who invented the 20th century, his contributions in the field of wireless technology, magnetism, and radio transmission shaped the world we know today. As you may know, however, Tesla died practically broke and mostly forgotten by many people. Except for a few of his inventions, many of his technology were seemingly lost to time or hadn't been implemented for some reason. But then, Tesla is just a part of a bigger and darker iceberg of conspiracy. Because deep down in the rabbit hole are many, many other inventors whose creations suffered the same fate. Some were even supposedly murdered. But who were they, and more importantly, what and who threatened their creations from seeing the light of day? Vehicles run by water had been humanity's dream since the invention of automobiles. Jules Verne, in his book, The Mysterious Island, predicted
that water will one day be employed as a fuel, that hydrogen and oxygen that constitute it, used singly or together, will furnish an inexhaustible source of heat and light, of an intensity of which coal is not capable. Someday the coal rooms of steamers and the tenders of locomotives will, instead of coal, be stored with these two condensed gases, which will burn in the furnaces with enormous caloric power. I believe that when the deposits of coal are exhausted, we shall heat and warm ourselves with water. Water will be the coal of the future.
Many inventors are trying to make this dream come true. In the first video, we briefly talked about Stanley Meyer's water-fueled cars. Although he was subjected to criticism and even lawsuits for his innovative ideas, he continued to pursue his project until his sudden death on March 20, 1988, which was diagnosed as a brain aneurysm. But just before he expired in his brother's arms, he managed to mumble, "They poisoned me." His inventions were never studied or implemented by engine and vehicle manufacturers after that, although his developments are publicly available. Nor has there been any investigation into his brother's claims of intentional infliction of death. Unfortunately, this kind of thing is all too common in the world of science, especially when the interests of big corporations, organizations, and the government itself are at stake. It was just strange that even before and after Meyer, all attempts at creating mass-produced water-fueled vehicles had never come to fruition. One such people who attempted to turn this dream into a reality was Ilya Volkov. If you hadn't heard about Volkov, perhaps you might be more familiar with Yull Brown, the creator of brown gas. Born in Bulgaria in 1922 in a small village close to Varna, Volkov was enlisted in the Bulgarian Navy at an early age. He was due to start at Sofia Polytechnique to study electrical engineering, but the outbreak of the September 9, 1944 coup disrupted his plans. After spending 2 years in a concentration camp, Volkov fled to Turkey, where he was again locked for another 5 years. The arrival of the United States Army finally set him free. Ilya Volkov then changed his name to Yul Brown after a character from Jules Verne's. Brown would spend the remainder of his life as an engineer in Australia. In the 1970s, he began working on his life's work, a process in which fuel can be made from water. By separating water's two constituents, hydrogen and oxygen, Brown would then recombine the two gases into exactly the same proportion as they are found in water to create a powerful yet efficient form of energy, thereby eliminating the need for other non-renewable sources like coal and fossil fuel. The best part is the byproduct of the fuel was water vapor. In a way, it's like killing two birds in one stone, reduce our use of fossil fuel and carbon emissions. But like Meyer, Brown's inventions found no commercial success. It also wasn't taken seriously by the academia. And despite numerous interests shown by international governments like China, it was never used for mainstream applications. Brown died of kidney failure in 1998. Unsurprisingly, like many of other innovative inventions, Brown's gas was pushed to the fringes of scientific discovery, even labeled as pseudoscience by mainstream publications. Water-fueled cars might be the biggest sufferers of this blatant disregard by mainstream science. However, even electric cars, which some of us actually use nowadays, also received more or less the same treatment, especially during the early to mid-20th century, when there were serious concerns about the sustainability of the reigning source of energy, fossil fuels. Nicolae Vasilescu-Karpen was a Romanian engineer and physicist who was noted for a number of his works in the realm of elasticity, engineering, thermodynamics, telephony, and electrochemistry. His most controversial invention, however, was Karpen's pile. Karpen's pile was basically a battery that could generate electrical power without an external energy source. Most intriguingly, Karpen's pile was said to have the power to provide continuous energy for up to 60 years. The idea was that several pairs of different metals, such as gold or platinum, could create a thermoelectric effect when immersed in an acidic solution. The heat energy it generates would then be converted into electricity indefinitely, which could power anything, even a car. There had been a number of demonstrations to show that it works, and it did. However, because mainstream science declared it violates the second law of thermodynamics, this idea was never pursued nor taken seriously. And like Meyer and Brown's inventions, some people believe that there were concerted efforts to stop it from being actually realized because an almost inexhaustible source of energy would effectively make fossil fuel unnecessary. Another inventor who worked on achieving remarkable fuel economy was Tom Ogle. The difference is that he didn't try to replace fossil fuel with a better alternative, only to reduce the need to consume it by creating a revolutionary carburetor. Unfortunately, he died at a very young age and was probably murdered. In 1977, Tom became famous almost overnight when he drove a newspaper reporter from El Paso, Texas to Deming, New Mexico. He claimed that he could drive 200 miles only on 2 gallons of gasoline. Of course, everyone was interested if he could actually pull it off. And he did. While he didn't actually make it back to El Paso due to a rouge rock that punctured a hole in his car, he was only a few miles off from his destination. His demonstration attracted the attention of the whole country. 2 years later, he received a patent for his invention. It seemed everything was going well for Ogle. Then tragedy struck. In 1981, at the age of 26, Ogle was found dead in an apparent drug overdose. However, many people believed foul play was involved. After all, Ogle had just invented a device that could significantly lower gas consumption, thereby slashing big oil profits in significant percentages. Due to his death, his carburetor never reached the market. In fact, as early as the 1940s, rumors of reprisals by major car companies against inventors and car manufacturers who allegedly created disruptive technologies were quite widespread. Preston Tucker was probably a unique case in the saga of suppressed automotive technologies. He wasn't an engineer, strictly speaking. For the most part, he was a businessman and an automotive designer. Still, Tucker had a deep passion for automotive innovation, something which he channeled into his own ventures. He is perhaps best known for the Tucker 48, nicknamed the Tucker Torpedo for its revolutionary features. The Torpedo was a unique, innovative car that was not only ahead of its time, but left all competitors far behind. It features advanced safety measures, rear engine placement, and innovative suspension. It also had a design and central headlight unprecedented for its time, which made it unique. However, Tucker faced trials after trials, including lawsuits. Although he won the legal battle and his reputation recovered a bit, his company wasn't able to bounce back. He died at the age of 53 due to lung cancer. It was believed that Tucker had been a victim of conspiracy by big Detroit automotive companies. It didn't also help that Dun & Bradstreet purchased the name Tucker as their trademark, so he wasn't able to use it to name his cars. Whether these are conspiracy theories or not, the truth remains the same. In the face of giant corporations, shadowy government organizations, and even individuals who merely seek power, the path to innovation is fraught with challenges and dirty games. If all this has piqued your interest in the subject, we suggest you watch the first part of the series. Just click the thumbnail on screen now, and we'll see there in a second.